feeling great.
For those of you who missed our previous episode, I just want to recap a little bit of what we discussed yesterday. We talked about easy meditation, and this was very intriguing to me because I understood that easy meditation can be done throughout the day. You could be running your errands, you could be doing your chores, you could be resting, but in spite of that, you could be meditating. Now, isn't that intriguing? So we had in our studio Dr. Donika, who had helped us answer some questions. Dr. Donika is a doctorate in homeopathy, and she has been meditating since her childhood because she has been associated with Brahma Kumari since her childhood. So let us all welcome back Dr. Donika. Dr. Donika, we would like to welcome you back to our show.
Thank you. Om Shanti.
Dr. Donika, yesterday we left off with a thought on thoughts.
Yeah.
No pun intended, but this is where we left off. And what was interesting where we left off was you said that there are negative thoughts and then there are waste thoughts. And to me, I had no clue. To me, a thought is a thought. I mean, there's a situation, I react to the situation, and that's a thought. But what I understood from listening to you yesterday was that there are waste thoughts and negative thoughts, and probably there are many more categories that I'm not aware of. So today, could we please start with that? If you could elaborate a little bit on what waste and negative thoughts are.
Speaking in short, what we did yesterday, the negative and waste thoughts are a bulk of thoughts, we can say. Throughout the day, if we just observe ourselves and look into it, it has been found up in a research that the majority of thoughts in human beings today are negative and the waste thoughts.
Oh, that's alarming.
Yeah. So we will just know about these thoughts and then we will go to the next category of thoughts.
Sure.
The negative thoughts are the thoughts in which we see the negative qualities might be of ourselves, maybe inferiority complex or any negative quality of myself.
Okay.
Or it may be of others too.
Okay.
So somewhere or the other, we are on the negative aspect, that is, we are at the lower aspect of our energy when we see that this person is like that only. Howsoever I tell him that you have to do this thing, he will never listen to me.
So we are depleting our energy by staying into the negative pattern.
Yeah, very true. Okay. So this negative pattern is the pattern which is going on maximum today.
Oh, okay.
Because we have so many expectations from ourselves and from the others.
That's very true.
And it may not be very good expectations also, or it may be on the higher level also. So these negative thoughts deplete our energy.
Okay.
The another category what we were speaking was the waste thoughts.
Right.
Now the waste thoughts are the thoughts, as we say, the waste is anyhow waste, right?
Junk.
Yeah, junk. And if I give you a gift which is filled up with waste, will you accept it?
No, I'll throw it away.
You will throw it away.
Yeah.
But the thing is, we are accepting this waste thoughts today.
Oh, that's true.
The waste may be of the past, yes? Mm-hmm. The past grudges. Say, for example, if you see a person who might have said anything bad to you few years back, and after you see him, you recollect those memories. And you say, this person had told me 20 years back this thing, and I will never forget that thing.
It does happen. I mean, not only to me, but I'm sure some of our viewers may agree with that. We will definitely touch upon that later on, but it's not very easy to forgive. And so what you're referring to is the waste that comes in is because of a lack of forgiveness.
Yeah. And it may be that because we have the habit of recollecting it again and again. Somewhere or the other, I had put it in my subconscious mind. That's why I'm carrying it till today.
Right.
So the past experiences which we had, these categories may be of the waste thoughts. Along with it, the future expectations, like after 20 years, 30 years, even we think of the next generations too.
Oh, wow. Yeah.
Yeah. And these thoughts are not necessarily to be thought of, right?
But wouldn't you want to worry about like your kids and what's going to happen to them and, you know, the whole gamut of thoughts that comes with having children or even your own career, what's going to happen to me in future? And
you see, we think of our child that presently he is not doing this thing or that thing, and then we start building bridges after bridges after bridges, yes. and we go to somewhere else which is not necessary to.
Actually, I had read about something when you mentioned the word bridges, that we are building bridges that may not even exist.
Yeah, and these bridges which do not exist, we go on those bridges, it will lead us somewhere else. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. It's just like somewhere is going and going, and he doesn't know where he is going to land.
Right, right.
So what would be the journey like?
Yeah, very difficult. So the best part is to be in the present.
Yeah.
And try to curtail your waste and negative thoughts as much as possible.
And that's why it's said that we can learn from our past experiences. The past gives us the experience, right? The future is an expectation.
Sure.
But what is today we are having is the present, and that is called the gift.
Oh, and that's nice. That's very true.
Present is synonymous with gift.
Right, right.
So the present is the gift, right. And meditation teaches us to be in present.
Okay.
To enjoy this gift.
Okay.
That's why we see when we have this easy meditation, we have our life in an enjoyable moment. We enjoy in each and all circumstances with the people we are. We enjoy with those people. Mm-hmm. The atmosphere we have, we enjoy with that atmosphere. The things we have, we feel satisfied with those things, and we enjoy and take the pleasure of that moment.
Okay, that does seem a little bit, if I say very difficult, not even a little bit, but very difficult to me at this time. I'm sure as we go along this series in our journey, I'm sure you'll guide us so we can reach that level where regardless of who we're with, where we are, we'll be sure. In that peaceful, calm state of mind. Sister, can you also, now we've talked about two kinds of thoughts. There is waste and negative. Are there the synonym, or I should say the antonym of waste is productive and negative is positive. So just common sense tells you that there should be positive thoughts as well.
Yeah. After covering these two aspects, we can move to the essential or the necessary thoughts. Just like if you have a meeting today, you think that at this time I have to go to this meeting. After this, I have to take my other works to be done. So these are the essential thoughts which are necessary and mm-hmm. which are related to our routine work.
Okay.
So these are very, very essential. Meditation makes us keen with our regular thoughts.
Okay.
And we can say punctual too with it
mm-hmm.
because we live in the present.
Right.
After the third category, we have one more, that is the camera vision.
Oh, okay.
That is, when you see from the camera or you look at the mirror, you are what you are.
Mm-hmm.
The camera will show you that if you have any spot on your face, it will show you the same thing.
That's right.
So in the same way, these are the thoughts which are practical. Right? If you think that I have to go to this place and it will take 10 minutes. Mm-hmm. This is the practical aspect.
Right.
So these are the practical aspects.
Okay.
After that, we have one more, which is positive thoughts.
Okay. That's something we all are interested to know.
Yeah. And the meditation journey starts from the positive thoughts.
Okay.
Well, it's not only positive thoughts in meditation, but let us start with this. Positive thoughts are the thoughts in which we start looking the positivities in ourselves too.
Okay.
What positivities I have to concentrate on those, and I have to take my journey through those positive thoughts
okay.
to make me as a positive person.
Okay.
Along with that, we also see the persons from whom we were taking the negative aspects,
mm-hmm.
we change our vision now.
Mm.
Just if you have a black color specs or a black color goggle, you will look all the things to be in which color? Black color. And if you are having a red one, you will be looking throughout as red one. In the same way, these positive thoughts replace the negative thoughts.
Mm-hmm.
You are living with a person, you are staying with that person, and you see 99 negativities of him.
Mm-hmm.
But somehow, if we are told that at least try to find, he must be having at least one positivity in himself.
That's right.
In that person.
That's right.
So meditation first approach is that we start looking at the positive approach.
Okay.
And it really has a practical change.
Okay.
I remember one patient who had come to me
mm-hmm.
a few months back. He was studying his engineering, and when he came, he said, "Doctor, I have a very severe problem." I said, "Yes." He said that I am in a very severe depression
mm.
and I need your help and guidance.
Mm-hmm.
And I asked him, what's the problem with you? He said, I have failed several times in my engineering and now I think that I won't be able to pick up.
Oh.
I said, okay, can you tell me what's the problem? Then he started narrating all his problems. He said he has number of problems with his room partner. His room partner is not listening to him. I said, what's the problem? What is the aspect that is bothering you? He said that I clean my room and whenever I see, he makes it dirty. And any other thing? Say, whatever I tell, he never listen. I clean it, I say him, you clean it, he never will listen. And he started just, you can say, a number of series of negativities came out.
Okay.
I said, okay. After that, I asked that, is there any positive aspect you can find out in him? And he pondered. He had a thought for a few seconds. And after a few seconds, he said, yes, doctor, there are. I said, can you please tell me? He said, he is very good in mathematics. Mm-hmm. And whenever I have problem, he guides me. And not that only, during the exam time, he sits throughout the night and helps me out with that problems. I said, oh, that's perfectly good. You had got a free tutor for it.
There you go. Yeah.
And I asked, anything else? He said, yes, one more thing. I said, what? He said, whenever I need money badly, he gives me.
Okay.
Oh, then I said, it's very good of him. Mm-hmm. Anything else? Say, yeah, one more thing. What? He said that the money he gives, when I returns him back, he never takes. He was so much pleased with that he never had thought on that thoughts.
Mm-hmm.
And when he changed his vision, I said, now, whenever you get the negative thoughts of that person, you just replace those with this positive thoughts.
Okay.
He said, okay, doctor. After a few weeks, he came for follow-up and he said, now the things are changing. His mindset is becoming calm now,
mm-hmm.
and he has started relaxing and he is able to do the things with some positive aspect. Okay, I said, you continue with this. After a few months when the follow-up was given and he was very happy, he had brought the sweets with him and he said, doctor, there is very good news.
He passed his exam.
Yeah, he passed.
How wonderful.
He passed his exams. Along with it, there was very astonishing thought by him. He said that yesterday one miracle had happened.
Mm-hmm.
I asked, what was that miracle? I said, yesterday was my birthday. Throughout these days, I was cleaning my room. I was making all the precautions to take it clean and tidy. But yesterday, when I went to the room, I was shocked to see that the room was so much clean that even I had not taken that much care of it. And one more thing he said, not only that, I was so much surprised because my room partner had arranged a surprise birthday party for me.
Oh, very nice. Very nice.
So that's the thing.
So he got two birthday gifts.
Yeah,
Clean room and one was his birthday party.
But can we say that this was his own thoughts production?
Very true.
When he was having the negative thought production, he was passing the negative energy to mm-hmm. his room partner. The mm-hmm. same was generated back. But now what the deviation has been there, now he started having a positive outlook for his room partner. Mm-hmm. Due to that positive outlook, the same vibration was caught by his room partner and the changes started gradually.
That's very, very important to know. And I think this is a very positive story. So we have found out that there are several different kinds of thoughts. And if we have a choice, why not hold on to positive thoughts? Because as sister told us, negative thoughts are depleting our energy. And positive thoughts are almost miraculous. I mean, they not only bring about a transformation in ourselves, but they can also bring about a transformation in people around us. So these positive thoughts are very empowering. So we have an option. We can either have positive thoughts or we can have negative thoughts.
Yeah.
So why not try to have positive thoughts?
That's very true.
Because what I learned from you today is positive thoughts have the power to not only change ourselves if we have positive thoughts, but to also change the people that are with us.
Mm.
And this is not just one person. I mean, if we bring that positivity to work, then there is a whole team of people we are working with. So we can extend that positivity to the whole group. And then I'm just thinking from what you've told me now, I'm just visualizing that it just can extend and extend and just spread the positivity all around.
Yeah, and that's why it's said that the problem till today was what? Everyone thinks of changing the world, mm-hmm. but no one thinks of changing himself.
Very true.
And this action should start from the thought point of view. Mm-hmm. So meditation is the journey beginning from the thought. And that's why we have the next step of thoughts after positive thoughts. When we start meditating, we find ourselves elevated. That mm-hmm. are the elevated thoughts.
Okay, so there is one more category of thoughts.
Yeah.
Okay.
So what we were saying, that negativities of others that were affecting us, when we have the aspect of elevated thoughts, then we can transform them easily into positive and we will be at a level of elevation.
Okay. So again, it seems to me that there is going to be some work. We need to put in some work into this to reach that level of elevation where we start influencing, you know, people around us.
Sure.
But that is, you know, good to know that there is hope. So we don't have to remain with our negative thoughts or our waste thoughts for the rest of our life.
Sure, definitely.
You know, we have something to look forward to.
Yeah. And that forwardness can come only with our personal determination.
Okay.
When we are determined, it's not that it's a one-day process that when we have heard this episode and now we can say that today, from today, we will be demolishing this waste and negative thoughts. It's not that. It's our own self-practice and it's our own self-determination. In meditation, when we sit or when we are doing anything and when we think that I shouldn't have these negative thoughts, the more you think, it may come. Yes, but slowly and gradually, we have to make mind our best friend.
Okay. Dr. Danika, that was a wonderful explanation about thoughts and how we can benefit from having positive thoughts. But for lack of time, I have a lot more questions on my plate, which I need to ask you. For lack of time, you know, we would like to have you back in our studio again. And could we continue this discussion with maybe understanding, getting a deeper understanding about going within is a very common phrase in meditation these days.
Yeah.
So maybe we can discuss a little bit about those perspectives.
Yeah, sure. And it's very essential for meditation because it's just the beginning aspect, and going within, this journey would really be interesting. And as we go within, we will find that we are getting more and more, we can say, in a crispy part, in the core aspect, and we will really love to enjoy this journey.
Okay, so thank you very much for being with us on the show, and we definitely look forward to having you again in our next episode.
Sure, welcome. I'm Shanti.
So friends, I hope you've enjoyed this show as much as I have. And, you know, it was very interesting to find out about these different categories of thoughts. Not only thoughts have a big influence on us, but it can have an influence on the surroundings as well. And I have understood today that we can actually have elevated thoughts. And these elevated thoughts can even influence the surroundings in a positive way. So that is very important to know these days, because all around you see like people do have certain concerns and they are looking for maybe like a father figure. So if we can play some part in their life where we can help them, you know, with our energy and kind of pass on the good cheer, maybe that itself could do a lot of service to the society. So please do write us back, call us, email us, and let us know if you have any questions or any concerns. And we definitely look forward to seeing you on our next episode, which I think is going to be even more interesting than this one. So thanks for watching us, and we'll see you again.